Pierre won the October 1st election to be the new state capital city with over 27,000 votes. The first state legislature met 14 days after the election, with the Senate meeting in the Congregational Church and the House meeting in the old Hughes County Courthouse. The legislature picked R.F. Pettigrew and G.C. Moody to represent South Dakota in Washington, D.C. as United States Senators. The legislature adjourned until January 7, 1890. Pierre was in the middle of a building boom. Cutting it close, the temporary capital was completed on January 1st of 1890, just days before the start of the new legislature on January 7th. The wood frame building was located at what we now know as the intersection of Capitol Street and Nicolette Avenue. The House of Representatives had 124 members and 44 members in the Senate. Now that statehood had been granted and the newly elected officers were on their way to Pierre, Governor Millett said,
"It was just like a new couple preparing to start housekeeping for the first time. They did not have a single thing to commence on, not even a desk, a chair, nor any records until the legislature met in January and made a formal demand."
Desks, office supplies, and even the state seal would soon arrive. This was an exciting time for Pierre and South Dakota, but new battles were brewing. The South Dakota Constitution required that voters must decide on a location for a permanent capital during the November 1890 election. This time, Pierre and Huron were fighting to become the state capital. This was the first time Pierre considered the bonding of public property as a means of raising money for a capital campaign. Bonds were sold by the city. Private contributions were also used. Pierre raised $1 million and won the 1890 election, becoming the permanent seat of government for the new state of South Dakota. In 1903, the legislature once again considered moving the capital, this time to Mitchell. Senate Joint Resolution 1 asked for a vote of the people. Pierre again geared itself up to take part in another statewide election on the capital location issue. When Pierre was announced the winner, there was an almost universal demand that a substantial state building be erected to stop any further attempts at moving the capital.